Welcome to this short introduction on building your component structure in SERTICA. My name is Rasmus Hansen. I'm the head of the project department at Rina Digital Solutions. Today, I'll try to show you how you can improve your use of SERTICA and hopefully optimize your business. Components sit at the center of the maintenance part of SERTICA, and components are the key driver to doing all of your maintenance within the system. A component is required to do jobs, as an example. Today I'll show you a little bit about how components are structured, and I'll show you how you create new components and maintain your tree structure. Components inside SERTICA can be visualized in the component structure. You find that in the bottom of the screen down here, and when you press it, it opens up the tree structure that shows you all of the components created for this site. The components are structured in a tree structure, so I can drill down. In this case, I open up my machinery main components. I can drill further down, and then I have my two main engines. So this way, you can build a structure of components within your SERTICA. The tree structure here will show you also the attached jobs, requisitions, and so on that are present in your system. If I want to see the details of a certain component, I can click it once to get some simple details to the right, or I can click it twice, and that opens up the component screen, which is also used when I want to update information or if I want to create completely new components. To create new components inside SERTICA, you use the new button. That's located up here, and it's normally green when you don't have your pointer on top of it. If I click it, I'll start the process of creating a new component. You can see that the only field here that is highlighted is marked in red, and that is because I need to enter a component number. And that is the only required information when creating a new component. I'll give my new component a number, 601.3. In this case, I'm creating a new main engine. So I'll create main engine 3. And when I'm done typing in the information that I feel is relevant, I can press the save button. Now, if I create it like this and go back to my tree structure to see how it looks, I have a button up here for that. I can press this and it opens up the tree structure, and you can see now that this new component is located a little bit strange in the structure. And that is because it's very important when creating new components that you remember to give it the correct parent component, meaning you tell the system where it belongs in the structure. So to rectify this, I can click twice again on this to go to the update screen, and then I can select my parent component here to decide where I want it to belong in the tree structure. I can either type it in and search, or I can actually select the parent from the tree structure. So in this case, I want my parent component to actually be this one here, so that the new created component ends up on the same level as main engine 1 and 2. So if I do it like this, you can see that it inserts the information, and I then press save again. And then I can go to my tree structure again to see how the new structure looks. And you'll see that now the component is actually structured correctly, where I have my diesel engines for propulsion, and then below that I have main engine 1, 2, and 3. That is how components work inside SERTICA. I hope you've enjoyed this short presentation. I wish you a good day.
If you'd like to learn more about SERTICA and our modules, visit our website.